Thank you. Will everyone please stand for the platform party and faculty processional?
Thank you. gentlemen, it's my pleasure to welcome each of you to the fall 2012 commencement ceremonies. I'm Aubrey Lucas, and it's my privilege to return to campus and serve as the interim president of our university. Would you please remain standing for our invocation, which is to be given by our Student Government Association President, Jasmine Butler. Following the invocation, Trevor Smith will lead us in the singing of our national anthem, and we invite all to join in the singing.
Faculty, staff, students, and distinguished guests, we gather today to celebrate the achievements of this institution's most prized possessions, our scholars. Let's take a moment to reflect, to be still, to be grateful, and to be hopeful. We join together as we pause to meditate with hearts of gratitude for the many blessings that the university has afforded us. With reverence, gratitude, and rejoicing, may an abiding peace be with you this day.
Jasmine and Trevor, you now may be seated. Commencements at Southern Miss are wonderful occasions. It's on these occasions that we acknowledge the achievements of our students and recognize the contributions that family, friends, and the Southern Miss faculty and staff have made to the education of our graduates. So, it's a pleasure to welcome you to this celebration. At this time, I would like to recognize a number of special guests who are seated in the chair back seats in front of the faculty. First, I welcome Liz Cleveland, wife of our commencement speaker. Liz, stand up and let us recognize you. Hold your, well, that's okay, go ahead. And we're also pleased to have our speaker's brother, Bobby Cleveland. Bobby, please stand. And with him, a longtime friend of the Clevelands and all of us who've been around here for a while, Hamp Cook. Hamp, we're glad to have you here. So let's welcome those three guests. We are especially honored when members of our Board of Trustees visit us on these occasions. As I'm sure most of you know, the eight state universities in Mississippi are governed by a board of trustees consisting of 12 appointed members. These board members are public volunteers. They are not paid government officials. They're dedicated folks. They're very caring. And it is a great pleasure that I introduce the president of the Board of Trustees of Institutions of Higher Learning, Mr. Ed Blakesley of Gulfport. Mr. Blakesley, would you stand? And Dr. Doug Rouse of Hattiesburg, both of whom are with us today. Let's thank them for the work they do for our university. Now it is my pleasure to introduce members of the platform party who will not be presented later in the ceremony. And would you kindly reserve your applause until all of them have been presented? Dr. Joe Paul, Vice President for Student Affairs. Mr. Bob Pierce, Vice President for University Advancement. Dr. Tom Estes, Interim Vice President for Finance and Administration. Dr. Gordon Cannon, Vice Provost for Research. Dr. David Holly, Commencement Grand Marshal and Distinguished Professor. Mr. Jonathan Broom, Vice President of the Graduate Student Senate. Dr. Susan Silton, Dean of the Graduate School. Mr. Ed McCormick, Associate Dean of University Libraries. Dr. Mary Ann Adams, President of the Faculty Senate. Mr. Tim Laird, President of the Staff Council. Mr. Michael Bonnet, our ceremonial reader. And Mrs. Margot Busson, who is providing sign interpretation for today's ceremony. Let's recognize these friends with an applause. Now it is my pleasure to introduce our distinguished speaker. For more than 40 years, our speaker and acclaimed sports journalist has informed, entertained, and inspired readers across his home state of Mississippi and beyond. Few Mississippians possess greater insight or passion about the glorious history of sports in the Magnolia State. A native of Hattiesburg and a 1975 graduate of this university, he is the most decorated sports journalist in Mississippi history. He began by covering high school football games for the Hattiesburg American, our local paper, while he was still a junior in high school. His talents eventually led to sports editor positions for the Hattiesburg American, the News Star in Monroe, Louisiana, and the Clarion Ledger in Jackson, where he served for 33 years. His reporting and writing have produced scores of state, regional, and national awards. In 2011, he became the first sports writer ever to be honored with the prestigious Richard Wright Lifetime Achievement Award for Literary Excellence. Previous winners include such noted authors as Eudora Welty, Richard Ford, Willie Morris, and from our own faculty, Dr. William Scarborough and Dr. John D.W. Geis. He's the author of three books, and he received the Distinguished Mississippian Award from the Mississippi Press Association's Education Foundation in 2000. On May 1 of this year, he assumed a new challenge as Executive Director of the Mississippi Sports Hall of Fame and Museum, located in Jackson. Our speaker is the son of Southern Miss Hall of Famer Ace Cleveland, the university's longtime sports information director. His mother, Carrie, worked for 20 years in the campus bookstore. His brother, Bobby, whom you just met, another distinguished Mississippi journalist, also graduated from Southern Miss. Rick and his wife, Liz, the manager of Global Business Division for the Mississippi Development Authority, are the proud parents of two children. Son Tyler Cleveland is currently a student here at Southern Miss, and daughter Annie Cleveland is a Chicago stage actress. She was a Southern Miss Honors graduate in theater here at USM. What a talented family. I'm honored to welcome a distinguished member of our Southern Miss family to give our commencement address. Let's welcome Mr. Rick Cleveland.
Thank you, Dr. Lucas. Boy, last time I saw this many people in this place, Clarence Weatherspoon was playing basketball at Southern Miss. I think they'd love to have this kind of basketball crowd at USM right now. This is a celebration today. So let's begin this celebration the way any event such as this should begin. Parents of graduates, friends of graduates, professors, and graduates yourselves, let's have a huge round of applause for your accomplishment. You've earned it. Congratulations. Thirty-seven years ago, I wore a cap and gown in this same building. I cannot for the life of me remember who gave the commencement speech that day. What I do remember is that the same good and wise man who will give you your diploma today and shake your hand was the man who handed me mine. So at this point, I want to pay special tribute to Dr. Aubrey K. Lucas, a gentleman and a scholar who has given so much of himself to the University of Southern Mississippi. Dr. Lucas, thank you. And from all the reports I'm getting, you hired a heck of a football coach this week. I tell you what's really cool. Dr. Lucas, you handed me my diploma at the close of your first semester at the university as president of the University of Southern Mississippi, and I am giving the commencement address at what we assume will be your last. Of course, with you, you never know. And if that makes you feel old, I'm sorry. Sometimes the truth hurts. Another loyal USM servant, Dr. Joe Paul, one of my closest friends, ends every email or letter he sends with these words, "Leave it better than you found it." Dr. Lucas, you, sir, have always done that. And so have you, Joe. Thank you for your many years of dedicated to our of service to our university as well. My association with Southern Miss goes back much further than my college days. I was born here. I grew up on this campus. My dad was the director of public relations and then the sports information director at USM for more than 30 years. My mother worked in the bookstore for most of that time. My brother Bobby and I spent our formative years in the dormitory that's underneath the east side of M.M. Roberts Stadium. The dorm was called the Old Rock, and my parents ran the dorm. And that was where the jocks lived, the football players and the basketball players. So my playmates and babysitters were the athletes who not only won national football championships, but who also taught Bobby and me words that we weren't supposed to know at such a tender age. This is a true story. My mama fried a chicken one night, and that was a big treat for us back then. And both Bobby and I's favorite piece of chicken was a drumstick. And she put a drumstick on both Bobby and I's plate, on my plate. Bobby finished his before I even got started, and when I wasn't looking, he swiped mine. I was 5 and he was 4. And I thought to myself what my friends, the football players, would say. And so then I just blurted it out. "Bobby, you SOB, if you don't give me back my damn drumstick, I'm gonna kick your scrawny ass from here to hell and back." Daddy tried not to laugh. My mama cried. 6 months later, we were out of that dorm. And I learned a lesson that night that I'll never forget as long as I live. Ivory soap tastes really, really bad. In those days, the football field was our backyard. The basketball arena was then right across the street from our apartment. What was then the baseball field was our side yard. The tennis courts were right across the street. The library was two blocks away. The press box was directly above our apartment. This campus was a lot less crowded then. Parking, I can assure you, was not nearly so much a problem. But I want to tell you folks just a bit about how far this university has come, and I can really see it as I gaze out into the faces of the graduates. The USM I knew as a child was lily white. It served only slightly more than two-thirds of this state's population. That was wrong beyond words. It absolutely thrills me that my university has become the most diverse university in Mississippi and has led the way in that regard for years and years. Clyde Kennard, and I hope some of you have learned that name since you've been here, would not believe the changes that have taken place at USM. So much else has changed. In my journalism classes, we typed our stories on manual typewriters. You got to go to a museum to see one of those these days. We took five newspapers at our house back then. Five. Two of those papers no longer exist. One prints only three times a week. And yet there's more information out there today than there's ever been before. It just comes in so many different forms. Many of you, I know, get your news on your cell phone. When we launched our new website at the Mississippi Sports Hall of Fame and Museum just a few weeks ago, only 30% of our website visitors found their way there from their computers. 70% found their way there from their cell phones. That just blew my mind. I don't know where this is all headed, and I'm almost scared to find out. What hasn't changed with all the advancement in technology is the value of words. Whether you read them in newsprint, iPads, Kindles, between the covers or book, or on your cell phone, words matter. Mark Twain said it best, the difference between the right word and the almost right word is like the difference between lightning and the lightning bug. That's a pretty profound difference. And I can't tell you how many times in a 40-year writing career I probably should have been struck by lightning. Words matter. Sentences and paragraphs matter. My late friend Willie Morris, the splendid Mississippi author, once told me, "Ricky, the English language is truly wonderful. I have found that if you search long enough, it will always provide you with precisely the right word." My daddy gave me the best writing advice I ever had. I was a 13-year-old eighth grader. I rolled a clean sheet of paper into my Underwood typewriter, and 30 minutes later, that page of typing paper was still clean and white. "What's the matter, boy?" my daddy asked. "I don't know how to get started," I answered. Dad's advice, "Just write it the way you would tell it." And so I did that night, and I have used that advice ever since. Years later, Willie Morris took it a step further. He said, "Write it the way you would tell it to one of your closest friends or a loved one. That way you'll always be more careful and you'll be more personal. Willie was right. Willie was also right when he said that all writers write best about what we care about most. Those of you who go on to become teachers might want to remember that. If your students are reluctant to write, have them write about what they love, whether it's baseball or Xbox, what they saw at the movies last night, or anything. Just get them started. You have to get them started. Now, these commencement addresses, I'm told, are supposed to provide you with wise advice about what the future might have in store for you graduates. That's probably way above my pay grade. And to do so, I would have to ignore the advice of the most sage of all American philosophers, Will Rogers. Mr. Will Rogers, a wise, wise man, advised that above all else, we should never miss a good chance to sit down and shut up. Instead, I will take the advice of Horace, the great Roman poet who died 27 years before the birth of Christ. Wrote Horace, who obviously was a wise man, "Whatever advice you give, be short." So I'm going to be short. The very best advice I ever received was from my daddy. He told me to choose an occupation where it didn't seem like I was going to work. And that's what I did. It has served me well. I spent more than 40 years getting paid to go to ball games. That's not a bad gig. I've written about thousands of games, including 30 Super Bowls. Of course, my daddy also told me that if I chose to be a sports writer, that I was never going to be rich. He was all too right about that. But the rather obvious lesson here is that money does not necessarily buy happiness. I could have made much, much more money had I chosen another profession, but I would have never had so much fun. I would never have been so passionate about what I was doing, and I don't believe I would have led such a richly rewarding wife. The same was true of my parents. They loved this university so much that it never seemed as if they were going to work. They adored this place. They had many, many opportunities to leave, but they never did. They really did bleed black and gold. President Harry Truman once said that the very best advice you can give your children is to find out what they want to do and then advise them to do just that. That's pretty good advice if you ask me. I have given both of my young'uns, one who still attends USM and writes about sports, and another who is an actress in Chicago and came through this splendid theater department here at USM, I've given them that same advice. So my advice to you, above all else, do something that makes you happy. Do something that doesn't seem like going to work. And then do it the best you can. Do it the best you can possibly do it, and leave it better than you found it. My next advice, your education surely does not end here today, no matter which degree you are receiving. If anything, your education jumpstarts today. The technological changes we've seen in your lifetime will increase exponentially over just the next 5 to 10 years. You must continue to learn just to keep pace, and you will. I am 60 years old, and I am learning something new every day, thank goodness. To close, I wish you happiness. I hope you do something you love, and I hope you do it well. And I also hope you will always remember the University of Southern Mississippi and Hattiesburg as fondly as I have. I trust that you will have left this place better than you found it. And I hope you will always come back. And now I will follow Will Rogers' advice, and I will sit down and shut up. Thank you.
Isn't he good? That's wonderful. And of course, I invited him because I knew he'd say something nice about me. Rick, we're indebted to you for good advice. I now invite Dr. Fred Drews, president of the Southern Miss Foundation, and Mr. Dale Scherer, president of the Southern Miss Alumni Association, to the podium.
Rick, on behalf of the University of Southern Mississippi Foundation and the University of Southern Mississippi Alumni Association, Mr. Shearer and I present you with this gift as a token of our appreciation for your visit and your inspiring message this morning. This framed photograph of the Lucas Administration Building represents a campus icon here at the University of Southern Mississippi. We hope that you will be able to display this in your office at the Mississippi Sports Hall of Fame. It is a true honor to have you return to the campus and be part of this commencement ceremony.
Thank you so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're pleased to see so many family groups here at Commencement, and we understand that you as families are very proud of the achievements we celebrate today. May I request that we reserve our applause and all other forms of recognition until all diplomas have been awarded in each degree category, and then we will give hearty applause, any way you want to do it. But if you'll just wait until we get to that time, if we can do that, your cooperation will ensure that everyone can hear the names of all of our graduates, and of course, it will also prevent our ceremony from being unnecessarily long. So thanks for giving attention to this request. At this time, I ask our provost, Dr. Dennis Wiesenberg, to come forward.
Will the candidates for the Doctor of Musical Arts degree please stand? President Lucas, these candidates have been approved for graduation by their dean and faculty. I recommend that you confer upon them the degree of Doctor of Musical Arts.
Dr. Wiesenberg, on your recommendation, with the approval of the faculty and by virtue of the authority vested in me, as president of the University of Southern Mississippi, I confer upon these candidates the degree of Doctor of Musical Arts with all the rights and privileges thereto appertaining.
Please be seated. Now, will the candidates for the Doctor of Philosophy degree please stand? President Lucas, these candidates have been approved for graduation by their deans and faculty. I recommend that you confer upon them the degree of Doctor of Philosophy.
Dr. Wiesenberg, on your recommendation, with the approval of the faculty and by virtue of the authority vested in me as president of the University of Southern Mississippi, I confer upon these candidates the degree of Doctor of Philosophy with all the rights and the privileges thereto appertaining.
Please be seated. Now, will the candidates for the Doctor of Nursing Practice degree please stand? President Lucas, these candidates have been approved for graduation by their dean and faculty. I recommend that you confer upon them the degree of Doctor of Nursing Practice.
Dr. Wiesenberg, on your recommendation, with the approval of the faculty and by virtue of the authority vested in me as the president of the University of Southern Mississippi, I confer upon these candidates the degree of Doctor of Nursing Practice with all the rights and privileges thereto appertaining.
Will all of the doctoral candidates and their major professors rise and come forward for the hooding and awarding of diplomas? Christopher Lee Davis, Dr. Danilo Mazzadri will hood. Trevor Dangerfield Smith, Dr. Marianne Kyle will hood. David James Wozniak, Dr. Lawrence Guaz will hood. John Tilford Martin, Dr. Stephen R. Mosier will hood. Daniel Charles Welburn, Dr. Stephen R. Mosier will hood. Susan Johnston Bush, Dr. Cindy H. Godet will hood. Dion Marie Davis Green, Dr. Cynthia H. Godet will hood. Deborah Green Moore, Dr. Cynthia H. Godet will hood. Sherry Williams Canty, Dr. Janie B. Butts will hood. Rondrick Jawain Cowens, Dr. Kim M. LaDuff will hood. Rick Carl Krause, Dr. Carl A. Reese will hood. Melody Teresita Fisher, Dr. Jaywa Shen will hood. Anna Rebecca Halliday, Dr. Jennifer S. Shank will hood. Joshua Smith Hanna, Dr. Derek L. Patton will hood. Ryan Matthew Henserling, Dr. Derek L. Patton Will Hood. Cheryl Zippe Kirby, Dr. Heather M. Annulus Will Hood. James Corey Latta, Dr. Jamila Lairs Will Hood. Lana Adelaide McDowell, Dr. Daniel S. Capper Will Hood. Stephen Gerald Miller, Dr. Brent D. Hales Will Hood. Tracy Lynn Moore, Dr. Sherry S. Heron Will Hood. Haiba Salim Nakesh, Dr. Sherry S. Heron Will Hood. Jennifer Dell McLaughlin, Dr. John C. Meyer Will Hood. Leslie Yvette Rodriguez, Dr. John C. Meyer Will Hood. Andrew James Ray, Dr. Jeffrey M. Lotz Will Hood. Patrick Gerhard Ritchie, Dr. Keith V. Erickson Will Hood. Linda Marie Mobley, Dr. Angela S. Ball Will Hood. Claudia Lois Smith, Dr. Angela S. Ball Will Hood. Donna Lampkin Stevens, Dr. David R. Davies Will Hood. Joy Nicole Smithson, Dr. Stephen J. Vinette Will Hood. Rajanda Tamilsena, Dr. Prothopartham Biswas Will Hood. Xi Wu, Dr. Shou Zhang Will Hood. Zheng Jin Zhou, Dr. Alan M. Schiller Will Hood. James Dale Hurd, Dr. Patsy L. Anderson Will Hood. Teresa Lynn Langley, Dr. Karen L. Rich Will Hood. Terry Ginn Lemon, Dr. Sander B. Bishop Will Hood. Abby Duckworth McNeil, Dr. Anita D. Boykins Will Hood. Brenda Lee Phillips, Dr. Anita D. Boykins Will Hood. Sharon Elaine Vincent, Dr. Kathleen R. Masters Will Hood. Please join me in congratulating all of our doctoral graduates. Will the candidates for the master's degrees please stand? President Lucas, these candidates have been approved for graduation by their deans and faculty. I recommend that you confer upon them the master's degree.
Provost Wiesenberg, on your recommendation, with the approval of the faculty and by virtue of the authority vested in me as president of the University of Southern Mississippi, and pending completion of any remaining degree requirements, I confer upon these candidates the master's degree with all the rights and privileges thereto appertaining.
Will the candidates for the master's degree come forward and receive your diplomas?
Mary Catherine Abels, Valerie Orcutt Antisi, Alicia Terry Augustine, Olivia Lynn Barnard, Dante Ramon Benford, Brianna Lynn Bonner, Jason Randall Bowen, Rachel Eileen Bruton, Nikoni Nishan Brown, Rodney Evans Brown, Alicia Marie Byers, Samuel D. Clardy, James Mitchell Clark, Janie Ruth Coleman, Diane Renee Coughlin, Jennifer Mary Crossland, Brittany Alicia Daniel, Julia Walker Downauer, Daryl Keith Dixon, Tabitha Danae Epperson, Donald Joseph Garrett. Maheshwar Gamir. Jonathan Bradley Gilmore. Lana Andrea Pugh. Megan Elizabeth Gray. Kimberly Jordan Griffith. Courtney Marissa Harris. Lee Christian Haas. Jessica Leanne Broadus Himby. Keith Jared Hollingsworth. Rebecca Lindsay Janvrin. Shin Jin. Frank Lee Johnson. Edith Nicole Lambert. Channing Elizabeth DeRoche. Kejia Lynn. Elizabeth Ann Alsop Lobmeyer. Leslie Thagard Lovelady. Faisal Bukhar Malam. Tandy Martin. Samantha Birch McGill. Deneen P. Minke. Stephanie S. Messer. Christy Klein Murphy. Smita Nepal. Nikki Ray Neeson. Monica Joy Nick Stidham. Kristen Howell Owens. Laura Lynn Phillips. Jessica Ross Pretty. Amanda Lee Pishu. Bethany Bateller Sabins. Monica Stennis. Sarah Teresa Savage. Jill Lauren Shoemaker. Megan Ann Tanner. Shaquilla Nicole Thompson. Rachel Nicole Williams. Garrett Michael Wright. Lejuan Yang. Georgia Christine Yeager.
Please join me in congratulating all of our graduates receiving the master's degree.
Provost Wiesenberg will now present the candidates for baccalaureate degrees.
I ask the deans of the colleges to present their candidates for the baccalaureate degrees. Dr. David Davies, Honors College.
Will the candidates from all of the colleges who are graduating with Latin designation through the Honors College please rise and remain standing? Provost Wiesenberg, these students have outstanding academic records. Those graduating with Latin designation have successfully completed a senior thesis and have earned the designation cum laude, magna cum laude, or summa cum laude. Their degrees will be awarded by the college of their major, and I am proud to present them to you. Candidates, you may be seated. Lastly, I would like to ask Carlton Anderson to stand and be recognized. Carlton had the distinction of carrying the Honors College banner today because he has earned the highest GPA on the most hours of any Honors College student in today's ceremony. Carlton, a geography major from Biloxi, represents the highest standards both of the Honors College and of the University of Southern Mississippi. Please recognize him and the excellence he represents with your applause.
Dr. Stephen Mosier, College of Arts and Letters.
Will the candidates for the bachelor's degree in the College of Arts and Letters please rise and remain standing? Provost Wiesenberg, these candidates have been approved for graduation by the faculty in the College of Arts and Letters. They are ready to have their degrees conferred pending completion of all degree requirements. Candidates, you may be seated.
Dean Catherine Nugent, College of Nursing.
Would the candidates for the bachelor's degree in the College of Nursing please rise and remain standing. Provost Wiesenberg, these candidates have been approved for graduation by the faculty in the College of Nursing. They are ready to have their degrees conferred pending completion of all degree requirements. Candidates, you may be seated.
Dean Joe Whitehead, College of Science and Technology.
Will the candidates for the bachelor's degree in the College of Science and Technology please rise and remain standing? Provost Wiesenberg, these candidates have been approved for graduation by the faculty in the College of Science and Technology. They're ready to have their degrees conferred pending completion of all degree requirements. Candidates, you may be seated.
Will all the candidates for the baccalaureate degrees please stand? President Lucas, these candidates have been approved for graduation by their deans and faculties, and I recommend that you confer upon them their degrees.
Provost Wiesenberg, on your recommendation, with the approval of the faculty and by virtue of the authority vested in me as president of the University of Southern Mississippi, and pending completion of any remaining degree requirements, I confer upon these candidates their respective bachelor's degrees with all the rights and with all the privileges thereto appertaining.
Students, please come forward and receive your diplomas.
The following candidates will receive a bachelor's degree from the College of Arts and Letters. Jared Landon Hayes, cum laude. Matthew Allen Cole. Charlotte Debrell Bauer. Jessica Rebella Ewing, honors. Anna Joe Berry, honors. Michael Dennis McFadden, honors. John C. Abate. Stephanie Faye Craig, magna cum laude. Joseph Hinton, highest honors. Jesse Elizabeth Pendergast, honors. Jeremy Denver Britt. Casey Noel Campbell. Leland Kyle Williams, honors. Sarah C. Curtis. Catherine Emily Wilson, honors. Cassandra Lane Cole. Tabari B. Daniels. Ariana R. Hansen, highest honors. Tyler Willis Covington, honors. Lysandra C. Everett. Johnette LaVon Johnson. Roland Joseph Diaz, honors. Carly Marie Rentz, honors. Candace Mazelle Couch. Patrick Casey Dillistone. Lauren Lang Schober, highest honors. Stephen Benson. Pamela Stinson, highest honors. Troy Alexander Albritton. Heather Carissa Peak, honors. Olivia Maria Jarman, honors. Jordan Lee Gasparis, honors. Kyle Leon Etheridge, highest honors. Blakely Elizabeth Tanner, highest honors. Anna Darling Bryant, honors. Jessica Brewer, honors. Jennifer Ann Everett Hutchinson, highest honors. Diana Mary Lillian Blackston. Nikki Louise Shelton, highest honors. Alyssa Lynn Butler. Daphne Charnice McNair. Tiara LaFleur. Mark S. Hildebrand, Jr. Philip Kyle Lancaster. Tabitha N. Hasty. Hannah E. Holloman. Henry Charles Flowers III. Orlando Stevenson Jones, Jr. Dallas Eldridge Medlin. Keenan Lee Dollar. Caitlin Elaine Johnson. Emily Renee Lee. Katie Devlin Donahoe. Alicia Kristen Fry. Jonathan Michael Melton. Kelly A. Leek. Carolyn Michelle Husbands. Inishan Loterio McGee. Riandra J. Green. Christina Hazelbaker. John Ashton Rushing. Claudia Alejandra Meza. Erica Lauren McDaniel. Kelsey Susanna Buckman, highest honors. David A. Garcia, Jr. Charles D. Jackson. Brittany Shavonda Harvey. Morgan LePre McMurtry. Keandria Nicole George. Benjamin Nicholas Gilkey. Amanda Marie Fuselier. Shauna Nicole Lewis Guidry. Haley D. Foreman. Matthew Wayne Gertz. Myron Kapitschik. Tori Elizabeth Frazier. Diva Griffin. Evan Elizabeth Flanders. Jared Thomas Favre. Courtney Tiara Jones. Jason Stone. Robert Charles Terrell. Prentice Edward Smith IV. Miranda Nicole Stewart. Paige Denise Nikes. Mia Miranda Pamphlet. Catherine Rose Martell. Ronalda Francesca Thomas. Carlos R. Nine. William Gallo Price. Pamela Mary Vitek, honors. Franz P. Gambe, honors. Anna Colby Tanner. Kimbra Marie Brazil. Brett Todd. Amber Lynette Travis. Jessica L. Miller. Chantel Lachey Upshaw. Kevin Anthony Jones. Keenan Terrell Walker. Jennifer Faye Jordan, honors. Anna Marie Keaton. Crystal Jean Sable. Holly Nicole Shankin. Devin Mariana Otis. Kristen Nicole Twelly. Alex Lucas Royals. Jonathan M. O'Keefe. Tiara Marie Sawyers. Zachary Harrison Rose. Jennifer Lynn Mountjoy. Sky Bailey. Brenda N. McClurkin, Lakeisha Marie Robertson, Joe Allen Wright, John Thomas Monroe, Luis Vicente Solis, Susan A. Slade Obrey, Garrett Simon Shelton, Helen E. Polan, Octavius K. Cole, Joseph L. Bishop, Frentoris Katera Bowie, DeMarcus Marshawn Butler, Michael William Sago, Walker Gaston Chancey, Megan Elizabeth Baratti, Jeremy O'Quinn Bridges, Tamika Ebony Buckley, Kinley Michelle Payne, Simarjit Tiny Ponder, Santana Victoria Barnett, Bianca Simone Arrington, Kiara Shante Grover, Jesse Scott McDonald, Hagar Quasha Simpson, Brian D. Johnson, Marita Nicole Hall, Alicia L. McAfee, Lakesha Jamise Durden, Carol Adrian Mitchell, Grace Gilmer Kennedy Allen, highest honors, Megan Nicole Aishi, summa cum laude, Alexander Kyle Pickle, magna cum laude, Joe Duhon III, Desmond Demond Johnson, Darius Richardson Barnes, Ariel Shante Osuzu, Shelby Reed Ball Jr., Trace O. Abdul Hadi, Mirandi Jermiel Lott, Jasmine Tanisha Hayes, Crystal Hurd, Miriam Roshan Schaefer, Andrina Shani Grady, Corian L. Paget, Melody Nicole Franson Wright, Kenitra Eiffel Griffin, Tashika M. Williams, Amy Marie Stratton, Harold Joseph Powell Jr., Joshua Allen Elmore, Ross Huval Andrews, Brittany Michelle Hollifield, Will Taylor Richmond, Timothy Lance McMillan, Zachary Scott James, honors, Justin Emil Sims, LaQuinta Quinna Williams, Benjamin Allen Weldon, Shadrick Kennard Sims, James Brock Doliak, Chadwick Sweet, Brittany Nicole Wynn, Janae Aaron Crosby Brakefield, Samuel White, Sergey Habrobro, Jasmine Marche Neely, Grace Williams, Catherine Grace Cox, Carrie M. Walding, Adriana Rose Smith, Kiana Cliche Wallace, Trey Adderill Newsom, Robert Harris, Kiri Philip Waits, Andrew Espiritu Bautista, Jimmy Williams, Jasmine S. Nippers, honors, Daniel Watson Harrington, Lauren Powell, Susie Lee Davis, highest honors. Jacob L. Hennis. Lauren Michelle Taylor. Sierra Sky Bird, honors. Patrice Elizabeth White, honors. The following candidates will receive a bachelor's degree from the College of Nursing. Josie Munn West, honors. Megan Ashley Clark, magna cum laude. Karen Creel Ladnier, honors. Amanda Grace Woodall, honors. Courtney S. Breland. Amanda Lynn Cordray. Alicia Ann Duncan. Miranda Joy Martin, honors. Lydia Sue Burns, honors. Jennifer Michelle Smith, honors. Jeanette Alyssa Guild. Lucas Ray De La Riva. Clinton Davison Isom, honors. Anthony Chase Eubanks. Miller Kane Howell. Danielle Nicole Hamilton. Shelby Rian Bateman, honors. Whitney Lauren Johnson, honors. Ashley Nicole Anderson. Elizabeth Ann Hall. Alvina Yvette Evans, highest honors. Angelia Jean Yelverton, honors. Cherie Suzanne Persons Langley, highest honors. Sharday Nicole Hopkins. Terry Leanne Dawkins. Virginia Carol Brown. Kalinda Ann Gunn. Adrian M. Lowry. Lucy Raina Simmons, magna cum laude. Felicia Ava Cialino, honors. Carly Danielle Cochran. Anna Lauren Brown. Catherine Madel Jeter. Carly Marie Jones. Dustin Christopher Foster. William Matthew Clyburn. Tiffany Yvette King. Sam B. Malden. Michelle McCormick. Sarah Fair Small. Whitney Lee McNellis. Mary Claire Pipper. Gary Adam McPherson. Matthew Jules Morrow. Sheena Washington. Ryan Paul Wise. Samuel Aaron Walker. Laretha Williams. Lashundra Shanette Spates. Ruth Ann Powell. Brandy Diane Parker. Catherine Ann Markey. Hannah Grace Rush. Lakin Beth Taylor. Bridget Ann Whalen. Antoria Lachey Otis. Ashley N. Miner. Carl Ian Macon. Jared R. Sheridan. Brian Wood Sanderson. Laura Ellen Trotty. Katie Michelle Mobley. Brittany Lynette Poole. William Reese Nunnery. The following candidates will receive a bachelor's degree from the College of Science and Technology. Sheldon McKay. Crystal Parker, highest honors. Nicholas L. Emmerich, highest honors. Whitney A. Towns. Christy Shaky Monique Millsap. Christina M. Leitze, highest honors. Michael Arthur Emerson Logan, John Matthew Henderson, Kimberly Elizabeth McElroy, Matthew Douglas Stewart, Stacy Denise Randall Otis, Casey W. Henderson, Whitney Nicole Hutzel, Caitlin Noel Carey, Michael Pauly, Tessia Lucille Warren, Christopher T. Kingston, Michael Brandon Holmes, Bradley Redmond, Sean Wayne Martin, Joseph Keith Filippello Jr., Isaiah Edwards III, honors. Christopher Mobbs, highest honors. Justin D'Anthony Dyer, honors. Carlin Corin Wilson. Tiffany Early, honors. Jesse Cleveland. Annie Marie Jackson. Tamika Potter. Erica Raina Griffin. Catherine Victoria Meyer. Hannah Elizabeth Ryan, summa cum laude. Michael Andrew Hansen. Faniquia Mache McGee. Angela Darlene Nungesser, highest honors. Matthew R. Adams, honors. Jordan Marie Town, magna cum laude. Justin Michael Keller, honors. Carlton Peter Anderson, summa cum laude. David W. Ditsworth. Dragana Mladanovich Alford. Tony Ray Jones. Kimberly Nicole Collins. Dejron D. Ellis. Lashundra McCann Jasper Barnes, honors. William Grant Kuhn. Jared Elijah Smith, honors. Jennifer N. Bird. Jessica Ellen Vidal, honors. John Thomas Howell. Aaron Daniel Ayers. Nevada Lindsay Brown. Tiffany Belinda Meadows Augustin. Erica Danielle Davis. Brandy Lynn White, honors. Kirby S. Irby. Joshua William Hurd. David Edward Clyburn Jr. Cindy Chong Lee. Banaz Bailey. William Lee Goodman. Peach Brandy Lee Hollis Brooks. Amir Jabril Jackson. Ashley Dominique Butler. Reginald Bernard Creer. Karen F. Marcioni. Brandon Joel Boyington. Amber Elizabeth Cabanis. Jack William Least. Bradley Scott Boyd. Glenn Banks. Christopher Michael Evans. Bryce Clinton Fulton. Sherry Lynn Robertson, honors. Regina Chambers Shabazz, honors. Jennifer Ferris Foster, honors. William Quentin Davis. Robert Benjamin Rippey. Michael David Payne. Christopher Anthony Violetta. Baron Terrell. Jonathan Thomas Poole. Caleb Alfred Weeks. Brett Lee Urbanich. Lauren Elizabeth Allen. Andrew Wayne Allen. James Chase Obrey. Prentice D. Windham. Jerry Daniel Welch, Richard Jacob Ulland, Kevin M. Tron, Julian Christopher Williams, Tatiana Dariel Porte, Madeline F. Meeker, Catherine Jane Salinas, Akeisha Yvette Wooten, Vernon Christopher Smith, Erica Dawn Patman, Breck D. Shoemaker, Stephen D. Valliere, Patrick Robin McKinney, Ross Curtis Neal, Brendan T. Nance, Stephen Ross, Jacob Wesley Perkins, Kevin Douglas Plash, Eric Xenophon Post, Tony Jermaine White, Ashton Kingsley Reeves, Nathaniel Anton Escobar, David Michael Yinney, Richard Roberto Marrero,
It's a happy day, isn't it? Oh, it's a happy day. Undergraduates, you've come now to a long-awaited milestone in your lives, the moment when you're no longer students, but you're graduates of the University of Southern Mississippi. Now, tradition requires that before graduation, the tassel be worn on the right-hand side. After graduation, as a symbol of your new status as degree holders, the tassel is worn on the left. So now let's all move that tassel from the right to the left. Okay. Good. I could tell this was a smart class, and you'd be able to do that with little trouble. Yesterday, one of the finest students in this university was commissioned an officer in the United States Army. He is Second Lieutenant Matthew Mara. Okay, Matthew, there he is. Let's give him hearty applause. Thank you. Also, I would like to recognize several of our graduates who are McNair Scholars. Their names are also listed on page 36 of your program. You can turn there now. And as Ronald McNair Post Baccalaureate Achievement Program Scholars, these students have completed a rigorous program of academic study, including a thesis and a formal presentation of their research. Would our McNair Scholars please stand at this time and receive our congratulations? McNair Scholars, would you stand? Okay, yes, very good. All right. Thank you. Here at Southern Miss, we have a tradition of recognizing our graduates' families who have provided support, financial, emotional, and other ways to our graduates. So I want to ask the parents, the spouses, the grandparents, the brothers, the sisters, the sons, the daughters, the aunts and the uncles, the cousins, and the neighbors, any other relatives and close friends who are here to celebrate this, would you stand and let the graduates thank you for, yeah, that's right. All right. Okay. Good. Okay, listen to this. Another tradition here at Southern Miss is that our graduates are given the opportunity to thank our faculty and staff. So, ladies and gentlemen, I want you to know that the faculty and staff at this university are truly outstanding. Graduates, you've been taught well, you've been challenged, you've been nurtured, and you've brought to this defining moment in your lives, in great part by this faculty and staff. Now, the faculty is seated behind you, the staff are seated throughout the Coliseum, but would you please stand and express your respect and gratitude to Southern Miss faculty and mentors, and they're right back there. And the staff are elsewhere. Yeah, that's good because they've not turned in their grades yet, and that just might help. Graduating students, on behalf of our Alumni Association, I welcome you to the growing group of proud alumni of this university. Your alma mater needs you to join that Alumni Association and to remain an active member. We need you to help us recruit students, to speak a good word about your university to all elected state officials, and especially to members of our legislature. And as you are able, contribute to our academic and athletic foundations. Stay in touch with us. Return for homecoming and other occasions. Thank you. Let us know about important events in your life. This university community is your family. Each of you can make a difference in the future of Southern Miss. Again, congratulations to all of you, the members of the Southern Miss graduating class of fall 2012. Southern Miss. Southern Miss. Great. Now, join us in the singing of our alma mater, which will be led by Trevor Smith, one of our graduates. Turn to page 53 in your program, and you'll find the alma mater. After the alma mater, I request that the audience please remain in place, first for the recession of the platform party, then the faculty, then the recession of the graduates. At the conclusion of the ceremony, guests and family members are encouraged to meet your graduates on the first floor of the Payne Center. P-A-Y-N-E, to those of you unfamiliar. To enable the preparations for our afternoon commencement ceremony, we're asking that our guests not come to the Coliseum floor. Thank you for joining us in this important celebration, and thank you for being a part of the University of Southern Mississippi. Let's now sing our alma mater. Trevor?
Send thy praise. sunshine, verdant trees and sheltering walls. Now hearts lift ever to thee as we praise thy hallowed
halls.